Is extremely high HDL beneficial or harmful? Too much of something good can be harmful, so goes the saying. Is this true in case of high density lipoprotein cholesterol, HDL also? HDL represents reverse cholesterol transport and is considered a marker of cardiovascular protection. But this view was challenged partly by a large study involving 631,762 individuals using big data approach. It was an observational study using CanHeart data set, which had 17 different individual level data sources. Study population had an age range of 40 to 105 years. They were residents of Ontario, Canada, without previous cardiovascular disorders or severe comorbidities. Mean follow-up period was 4.9 years and all-cause mortality was 8.1 per 1,000 person years in males and 6.6 per 1,000 person years in females. Those with lower HDL levels were likely to have low incomes, unhealthy lifestyle, higher triglyceride levels, and other cardiac risk factors and medical comorbidities. Low HDL levels were associated with higher risk of cardiovascular, cancer, and other mortality. The interesting finding was that those with higher HDL levels above 70 mg per deciliter in males and more than 90 mg per deciliter in females had increased hazard for non-cardiovascular mortality. This has been called the U-curve in case of HDL. Another important observation is that low HDL levels were associated with poor general health and unhealthy lifestyle. An earlier study in male smokers had shown that all-cause and alcohol and violence-related mortality was positively associated with HDL among younger men in the study population, which had an age range of 50 to 69 years. U-shaped dose response was noted in men 60 years or more in all-cause mortality. So there was a view that increased HDL in this study was due to increased alcohol intake. The EPPO Japan study checked the association of extremely high HDL with cardiovascular mortality in a pooled analysis of 9 cohort studies, which included 43,407 individuals. Extremely high HDL in this study was defined as HDL levels of 90 mg per deciliter or more. 4,995 all-cause deaths and 1,280 deaths due to cardiovascular cause were identified during the 12.1-year follow-up. Extremely high levels of HDL were significantly associated with increased atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease mortality with a hazard ratio of 2.37 in this study. There was increased risk for coronary heart disease and ischemic stroke. Risk of extremely high HDL was more evident among current drinkers. Another longitudinal study of 83,100 participants having mean age of 45.4 years had 4,475 participants with extremely high HDL above 90 mg per deciliter. This study showed extremely high HDL was associated with lower risks for all-cause mortality and cardiovascular events compared to low HDL. But they had higher risks compared to very high HDL. Paradoxically high all-cause mortality in those with extremely high HDL has also been reported in another study of 52,268 men and 64,240 women. Though most of these studies showed a negative role for extremely high HDL, there is a recent study from Korea which showed that extremely high HDL was not associated with increased risk of mortality, myocardial infarction, and stroke. That study with 343,687 subjects also defined extremely high HDL as 90 mg per deciliter or more. The median follow-up period was 6 years. So to conclude, the final word on extremely high HDL is still not available. We need large-scale population studies of longer period across multiple countries to see whether the U-shaped dose-response relationship noted in several studies is actually due to HDL or some other associated confounding factors. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.